was regarded as the cubical epithelium. These cubical epithelium are present in several layers. Unlike the pavement epithelium, which is only present in one single layer, cubical epithelium tissues are present inside the body of the animals in several layers. The several layers are attached one by one in our lateral surfaces with one another. These cubical epithelial tissues are present in several types of glands that are present inside the body of the living organism. These are present in the tubes of our kidney. The kidney comprises of the tubules, which are very, very important for our body. So the tubules of the kidneys, as well as the thyroid glands and tubules of the varieties of excretory glands that are present inside our body, even the layers of our uterus generally comprises of the, or generally are coated by this particular layer of epithelial tissues. This epithelial tissue that is present inside our body also helps in several varieties of the function that is performed by the epithelial tissue. They generally help in protecting the layers of the kidney. They generally help in protecting the internal layers of the kidney. They help in protection of the internal layers of our uterus, as well as the respiratory parts that are present inside the body of the living organism. Besides these, it also forms the covering. It forms outer covering, outer layer of the kidney, thyroid gland, respiratory pipes, or the layers of the uterine system, or layers of the uterus that is present inside the animal body. Besides these, it is also secreting the important hormones that are present inside the body of the living organism. So these pubertal epithelium, or the cubical epithelial tissue that is present inside the body of the animals, inside the body of the living organism or the animals, generally are such type of tissues that are made up of Q-shaped cells, that are generally made up of Q-shaped cells. Besides this pubertal epithelium or the cubical epithelium generally are made up of larger number of the cells, and they are generally attached to the basement membrane of larger number of the internal organs that is present inside the body of animals. These cells, which are cubical in nature, these cells are generally taller as well as they are wider in shape. These cubical epithelium are generally taller as well as they are also wider in shape. These cells are also very, very thick in their size. These cells are generally thicker in their size as well as they are also larger, and they comprises of large centrally located nucleus. The cells generally have the thicker, larger, as well as round centrally located nucleus present within them. Besides this, as we have already studied, they are more or less like cubin structure. The cells are more or less like cubin structure. Beside that, these cells generally form the outer lining of varieties of the inferior parts of our body. The respiratory tissues, respiratory organ that is present inside our body, as well as bronchial tubules of the kidneys and several other internal parts of our body, generally is layered with this particular type of tissue, which is regarded as the cubical epithelium. This cubical epithelium, as they cover several types of internal organs of our body, they help in covering, they help in formation of one particular layer that help in covering of the body, that helps to form the covering of the body, as well as these also help in protecting those internal layers of our organs, or protecting the internal delicate parts of our delicate organs. Besides these, it also helps in secreting varieties of the hormones that is needed, that is very, very important for the organs to perform properly, or for the organs to work properly. It provides the lining or the coverage to the internal structure. It provides the protection to the internal structure against the mechanical wear, mechanical tear off, as well as it also helps in secretion of the biologically active fluids. The several fluids that is needed for our body, those are secreted with the help of the glands that are present in the cuboidal epithelium or cubical epithelium. Besides this, it also helps in excretion. These tissues also helps in excretion, especially when the linings that are present in the kidneys, they particularly help in excretion of the harmful byproducts in the form of the urine. Similarly, the sweat glands that is present in our body, which is also coated with this cubical epithelium, they help in decorating, or they help in excreting the unwanted substances from our body in the form of the sweat or in the form of the oil product. Besides this, this cubical epithelium tissue also helps in transport of the materials from one part of the body to the another part of the body, specifically from outer surface of the kidneys, outer surface of the lung, outer surface of the other internal organs to the innermost part of these particular delicate organs that is present inside our body. So these tissues that are present in our body is also one of the very, very extremely important tissues that is present inside the animal body. Besides these, there is presence of the columnar epithelial tissues. The columnar epithelial tissues are the elongated tissues that are present inside the body of the living organism. The animal tissues, the epithelial tissues that is present inside the animal body, also comprises of the elongated tissues that is present inside their body, which is regarded as the columnar epithelial tissues. These columnar epithelial tissue generally forms the lining of stomach and intestine that is present inside our body. The columnar epithelial cells generally are the column-shaped cells. They are generally elongated and column-shaped cells which have a height of at least four or five times more height in comparison to their weight. So along with the cells, the nucleus that is present inside the columnar epithelial tissues are also very, very elongated. As the cells are elongated, the nucleus are also elongated and they are located near to the base of these particular cells. The columnar epithelial tissue generally forms the lining of the stomach and lining of the small intestine that is present in the animal body. It forms a single layer of the cell. Unlike the cubical epithelium, it forms a single layer inside the body of the animals, and it is generally found in the internal or inner lining of the ovaries as well as inner lining of the kidneys, inner lining of the small intestine, and inner lining of the stomach. Generally is made up of columnar epithelium. They may be in the form of the cube, or they may be in the form of the column itself. And they are also found in several other organs that are present inside our body, such as pharynx and larynx. Are also those organs which is coated with the whose inner part is coated with the columnar epithelial tissues. These tissues generally comprises of the hairy structure or hair-like structure, which is regarded as cilia. These cells or these epithelium tissues generally comprises of the hair-like structure, which is regarded as the cilia. Or cilia are present within the columnar epithelium. And these cilia generally helps in fluid movement, the fluid that is present inside the body of the animals, inside the various organs that is present within the body of the animals. The movement of these fluids generally are determined by the structure that is present in the columnar epithelial tissues. These cilia or this hair-like structure helps in determining the movement of the fluid from one part of the organ to the another part of the organ. Besides these, this also comprises several other functions. This also gives us several other functions for that. It has the secretion of several types of hormones, several types of enzymes needed for our body. It also helps in coating the gallbladder or the salivary gland. So it helps in secretion of those important substances that is present, that is needed for the gallbladder, that is needed for the salivary. Besides these, it also helps in absorbing larger number of the useful substances to the internal part of our body that is done by the columnar epithelial tissues. These epithelial tissues also help in secretion of the mucus. The epithelial tissues also secrete the mucus, which acts as lubricant, which generally acts as a lubricant inside the various organs that is present inside our body. The columnar epithelial tissues generally are divided into several types. They are single layer columnar epithelial tissues, or stratified columnar epithelial tissues are also present, which is generally in our salivary glands as well as in our eyes, pharynx, and many other organs are also coated with this particular epithelial tissue that is present inside our body. Besides this, this helps in secretion as well as this helps in absorption of the useful materials inside our body. Now, next one is the glandular epithelial tissues. The glandular epithelial tissue that is present inside our body generally helps in forming up layers, or forming the linings in varieties of the glands that is present inside the body of our animals. Varieties of the glands are present inside our body, as we all are very, very familiar. Larger number of the glands are found inside the body of the living organism or inside the body of the animal. So these glands are generally coated with one particular type of tissue, which is regarded as the glandular epithelium tissues. The glandular tissue that is present inside our body is made up of larger number of the cells. Like the other tissues, it is also made up of larger number of the cells, and it is a type of epithelial tissues which covers varieties of the glands, especially the exocrine glands and endocrine glands that are present inside our body. These glands are covered by the lining of the glandular epithelial tissues. Since it covers the glands of our body, the main function of these particular tissue is to help in secretion from varieties of the glands. As you all are very, very familiar, these glands that are present inside our body, the endocrine gland or the exocrine gland that is in the body of the animal, generally produce larger number of the secretion that is needed for our body, that is useful for our body, that is needed for varieties of the, to perform varieties of the activities inside our body. So these linings, these epithelial tissues, this glandular epithelial tissue basically serves the function of secretion, the secretion that is done by varieties of the exocrine gland and endocrine gland, that is done by the linings that are present, that are formed by the glandular epithelium. So we can say that the major function of this particular tissue is to secrete varieties of the enzymes that is needed for our body. Besides these, it also helps in secretion of the mucus, secretion of the saliva, digestive juices, which all are the important fluids that is needed to be secreted inside our body. This epithelium also forms the lines in our intestine. Our intestine is also coated with a glandular epithelium, which helps in absorption of the nutrients that is needed, that is inhaled inside our body in the form of the food. Those nutrients, after the breaking down of the food materials and after the breaking down of the nutrients, these are absorbed by the glandular epithelium, which is present in the lining of our intestine. So it also helps in digestion, as we can say, as it helps in absorption of the food materials, absorption of the nutrients. We can also say it also provides certain amounts of benefit in the digestion of the food materials inside the body of the animals. Any type of malfunction that occurs in the epithelium tissue, in the glandular epithelium tissue, if any type of malfunction occurs in any part of our body, in glandular epithelium, then several vital functions of our body cannot be performed properly, because this glandular epithelium tissue also helps to perform varieties of the functions inside our body. So given some of the observation of epithelial tissue, how epithelial tissues mucus generally is the excretory products that comes out from our body, such as from our nose, the mucus that comes from our nose. Yes, we all know comes from our nose, yes or no? Generally, that is the mucus. So basically, epithelial tissues can be observed under the microscope. Here is given the observation of epithelial tissue in the activity one. For that purpose, we need to scratch a piece of frogs or hens outer surface of the skin with a small stick. Yes, hens or frogs or any other organism. Just scratch the outer surface of the screen with a small stick and put the scratched material in the clean slide. The slide can be obtained inside the laboratory, clearly visible when we observe it through the microscope. So put a drop of iodine and cover the scratched skin with the help of a cover sleeve. Now keep the slide under the microscope and observe the material under the microscope very, very carefully. we can see the structure of the microscope, structure of the epithelial tissues, variety of the epithelial tissues, the general epithelial tissue, general structure of epithelial tissues can be seen under the microscope, which can be compared with the figures that are given in the book itself. Clear? So any problem about the tissues that are present in the animal body?
No, ma'am.
Are you sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
How many types of tissues are present? Two types. What are they?
Plant tissue and animal tissue.
Yes, plant tissues and animal tissues are present. Yes or no? Animal tissues and plant tissue both can be divided into several types. You all are very familiar. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Several types. There are generally four different types of animal tissues present inside the animal body.
Body.
We have already studied one of which we have already studied, that is epithelial tissue, muscular tissue, connective tissue, and nerve tissue.
Nervous
there tissue. Are several types of epithelial tissues present inside our body, such as pavement epithelium, cubical epithelium, columnar epithelium, and glandular epithelium. Besides this, there are also several other tissues that are present inside the body of the animal. Not only the epithelial tissues are present, but there is presence of connective tissue, muscular tissue, as nervous tissues are also present. Yes, which you have already done in your project work as well. Yes or no? So connective tissues are the types of the cells or the group of cells that help in connecting one part of the body to the another part of the body. The cells, the group of cells or the tissues that generally help to bind the other parts of the body together is regarded as the connective tissues. Clear? They attach the organs or the tissues together. Even the tissues of our bodies are attached together. Organs of our bodies are attached together with the help of the connective tissues. These connective tissues not only help in connecting the organs together, but they also help in storing the fat that is produced inside our body. They help in repairing the damaged tissues. In any cases, if the tissue is damaged inside our body, these also are repaired with the help of the connective tissues. Besides this, it also helps in preventing our organs, internal organs, from any type of mechanical shock that may occur to the varieties of the parts of our body. So basically, we can say connective tissues are those types of tissue that helps in binding of the varieties of the organs of our body, as well as they also help in, they also work as the mechanical defense system of our body, as it helps in repairing the damaged tissues, as well as it also helps in preventing our organs, preventing our body from any types of mechanical damages. Tissues are very, very important inside our body. Yeah. Similarly, there is also presence of muscular tissues. The muscular tissues are the tissues that are present throughout our body, and it also helps in movement and locomotions of our body. Each and every muscles that are present in our body generally comprises of the muscular tissues. There is presence of muscular tissues in our heart. There is presence of muscular tissues in our skin, as well as several other body parts. Several other parts of our body generally comprises of the muscular tissues. Muscular tissue generally comprises or generally can be divided into three types. That is cardiac muscular tissue, smooth muscular tissue, as well as skeletal muscular tissues. Cardiac muscular tissues are generally present in our heart, and it generally helps in blood circulation, as well as it also helps in pumping of our heart. The cardiac function of our heart generally is done, or the contraction and relaxation of our heart is generally done with the help of the cardiac muscles that is present, that forms the outer lining of our heart itself. Besides this, there is smooth muscular tissue. This smooth muscular tissue also helps in involuntary functions of our body. Skeletal muscular tissues are present, which helps in movement, or it also helps in providing support to our bodies. these muscular tissues that are present inside our body generally help in movement, generally help in locomotion of the different parts of our body or movement of the different parts of our body. It provides support to our bones as well as it also provides perfect structures to the different parts of our body, different organs that are present inside our body. Clear? Now, next one is the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue generally is present in the central nervous system of our body as well as the peripheral nervous system of our body. From the name itself, it is very, very clear the major function of this tissue. The major function of this tissue is generally to help in transmitting the nerve impulses to our brain. As long as the nerve impulses are transmitted to our brain can function properly and our brain can send the perfect instruction to the different parts of our body without any difficulty. So this particular work is done by the varieties of the nervous tissues that are present in different portions of our body. There are several types of nervous tissue that are present inside our body. Generally, this nervous tissue particularly helps in providing the structural and functional unit to our nervous system. They provide the support to the neurons and fibers that is present inside our body, as well as nervous tissue also helps in releasing varieties of the chemicals, which is directly mixed into our blood and help in performing different types of functions. So, these almost all types of tissues, whether they are the epithelial tissues, nervous tissue, muscular tissues, or the connective tissue that is present inside our body, each of these tissues are extremely important to the animal body, extremely important for performing varieties of the functions inside the animal body. Without these tissues, there will not be the protection of the internal layers of our body. There will not be the connection between different organs that is present inside our body, as well as there will not be the secretion of different types of enzymes, hormones of mucus, or even the digestive juices and saliva inside the body of the animal. So these tissues are very, very important to the animal body as it helps in performing, as it helps in completing varieties of the functions inside the body of animals, inside the body of living organism. Clear up to here?
Yes.
The next one is the plant tissue. The tissues that are generally present found in the plant body is regarded as the plant tissue. We all are very familiar about it. Yes. So how many types of plant tissues are present? How many types of tissues are present in plant? Can you tell me?
Some two types.
What are they?
Meristematic tissue and
permanent tissue.
Permanent tissue. So, since you have already done the study of this, what do you mean by meristematic tissue? Can you tell me what is meristematic tissue?
I mean, which cells are closely packed?
Yes, in which cells are present at the tip of the plant, and these tissues basically help in growth and development of the plants. If there is no presence of meristematic tissue, if the meristematic tissues are not present, if the tip of the plants are cut down, the plants cannot grow. We all know that, yes? If the tip of the plant, the plant cannot grow and develop properly. That is because tip of each and every part of the plant generally consists of this particular part of the plant, this particular tissue that helps in growth and development of the plant, growth and development of any parts of the plant. So meristematic tissues generally have the ability to enlarge the plant, generally have the ability in stretching of the plant, generally have the ability that helps the plant to grow and develop properly from younger plant to the grown up older plant. So these particular tissues, the meristematic tissues that are present in the tip of the plant, generally helps in growth and development of the plant. Meristematic tissues are generally present in the plant cell and they are generally oval and rounded in shape. Some of the meristematic tissues, meristematic cells, we can say, some of the meristematic cells that form the meristematic tissue generally are oval and rounded in shape, and some are also polygonal in see, when these meristematic tissues combine together, they form meristematic cells combine together, they form the meristematic tissues, and they are generally present at the tip of each and every plant. The intercellular space, the cellular space between different cells, that is present different cells of meristematic tissues, are very, very less, or we can say there is no cellular space between the meristematic cells. These cells may be very, very smaller in size, and these cells may be very larger in size. And these cells generally have the capability of dividing each other. That means they have the capability to divide each other so that the plant can grow quickly, the plant can grow and develop properly without any difficulty. These meristematic cells that generally helps in forming of the meristematic tissues generally comprises a very, very thin cell wall. As you all are very familiar, each of the cells that are present in the plant body comprises of the cell wall. So these meristematic cells also comprises of the cell wall, but in comparison to the other cells that are present in the plant body, they comprises of the thin cell walls. Besides this, other cellular structure that is needed for the cell is also present, but they are quiescent in comparison to the other cellular structure that is present inside the plant cell. Such as rather than having the thin cell wall, the cytoplasm that is present in the meristematic tissues or meristematic cells generally are very, very dense, like the other cells. Similarly, they also comprise of a clear nucleus. Similarly, these meristematic tissues basically is present in several parts of the plant. They are present at the tip of the plant, they are present at the tip of the root, as well as they are also present at the tip of the stem. So depending upon the location, depending upon where these meristematic tissues are present, they are divided into several types. They are the apical meristematic tissues as well as lateral meristematic tissues present inside the body of the plant. If the meristematic tissues are present at the tip of the root, tip of the stem, or tip of the any part, other part of the plant, these are regarded as the apical meristematic tissues. कुनै पनि plant को कुनै पनि part को सबैभन्दा टुप्पोमा यदि these tissues are present, they are regarded as the apical meristematic tissues or apical meristem. This generally helps in increasing the length of the root or increasing the length of the stem. Besides this, the meristematic tissues are also present at the lateral side of the root or the stem. Lateral side means at the other sides of the root or the stem, rather than or instead of the tip of the root and stem. Those are regarded as the lateral meristem. These lateral meristem generally helps in increasing the thickness of the root and stem. The apical meristem generally helps in increasing the length of the root and stem, whereas lateral meristem generally helps in increasing the thickness of the root and stem. How thicker the root and stem will become, that will be determined by the lateral meristem that is present in the lateral side of the root and stems of the particular plant. Yeah. So basically, we can say these meristematic tissues that are present in the plant body generally helps in growth and development of the plant, whether it is to increase the thickness of the body of the plant or it is to increase the height and length of the particular plant. Here is given another activity to observe the tissues that are present inside the plant body. For that purpose, we require a gram or the pea, and we need to soak gram or pea for some days in the water. After soaking it for some period of time, the small sprouts will be seen growing from the gram or the pea that has been soaked in the water for several days. Now, what we need to do is cut the tip of the sprout. We need to cut the tip of the sprout with the help of the sharp blade and put it in a clean slide. Make it flat. We need to make it flat by pressing it with another slide so that the tissues will be clearly visible inside the microscope. Now, put the few drop of saffronine to provide the color to the tissues so that it will be clearly visible, and cover it with a cover sleeve. Make it airtight so that no air bubbles will enter inside the sleeve. Now observe it under the microscope, and after observing it, compare the diagram that is given in your book with the diagram, that is with the figure that you see inside the microscope itself. So these things we can